Hello viewers, in the previous video session we have discussed about some Boolean laws. In this video session we are going to continue with the same and we are going to discuss some special laws in which first is a plus ab is equal to a. So this is one of the special law, a plus ab is equal to a. But even let us see whether really they are equal, both are equal to each other or not. So I will begin with the left hand side equation. So a plus ab, I write this on the left hand side equation. What is common in between these two terms? In these two terms the common is a. What is left in the bracket then? 1 plus b. If you remember the OR law what we had discussed in the previous video session. In the previous video session we had discussed one OR law which was 1 plus a is always 1. 1 plus a is always 1. 1 ORing with a is always 1. So 1 ORing with a is 1. 1 ORing with b will also be 1. So that is what? A. So 1 ORing with b will be 1. We had also discussed AND law in the previous video session where a ending with 1 is always a. A ending with 1 or 1 ending with a is always a. So a ending with 1 will always be a. And this is nothing but RHS. So this is the special law, a plus ab is equal to a, and that is what you have proved here. Second one. A plus a complement b is equal to a plus b. The second special law is a plus a complement b is equal to a plus b. Let us see, let us solve it. I again begin with LHS left hand side and I write it as a plus a complement b. Is there anything common here? Of course not. So what I do, I take the reference of previous law. What is it? A plus AB is equal to A. So can I replace this A as A plus AB? Of course yes. So I replace this A as A plus AB. I write the remaining term as it is, plus A complement B. Okay? Now, is there anything common in between these two? Yes. So I write first a as it is, plus as it is. What is common? Common is b. What is left inside the bracket then? A plus a complement. Again, we had discussed OR law. In the OR law which we had discussed in the previous video session, a plus a complement will always be 1. And we had also discussed AND laws. So with the help of AND laws, this a remains as it is, b into 1 will always be b, and this is nothing but the RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS, hence this is the second special law. Third one. A bar plus A B bar will be equal to A bar plus B bar. A complement plus A B complement will be equal to A complement plus B complement. Let us solve in the same way what we had did here. So I begin, I start with the LHS, which is A complement plus A B complement. Is there anything common between these two terms? Again, no, nothing is common. What do I do then? So, I write this A complement as it is. I write into 1 and AB complement as it is. What is difference between these two? the only thing added is a complement into 1, and you all know that anything multiplied by 1 remains the same. So a complement into 1 remains a complement. So mathematically this is valid. Next, instead of 1, I write 1 plus b complement. What I did, I written a complement as it is. Instead of 1, I replaced 1 plus b complement, because we have discussed 1 plus a is always 1. It means 1 plus anything, 1 plus a is always 1, 1 plus b is always 1. So 1 plus b bar must also be 1. So again, according to Boolean laws, this is valid. What I do is I expand the bracket, I expand them. So what happens? A complement multiplied by 1 remains a complement, plus a complement multiplied by b complement, so it becomes a complement b complement, plus a complement a b complement as it is. Next, what is common in between these two terms? Common. So I write first a complement as it is, plus the common between the both is b complement. What is remaining then? A complement plus a. First a complement as it is, b complement as it is. A plus a bar, a plus a bar is always 1. So a plus a bar will always be 1. And last, hence prove. Is it okay? So this is the third special law which is being proved here. So in this video session we have discussed about few special laws. So with the help of Boolean laws, we had even proved that the left hand side equation and right hand side equations are same. In next video session, we are going to solve few more examples wherein we are going to reduce the given Boolean equation using these Boolean laws. So I hope you have understood these special laws. In the next video session, we are going to see reduction of the Boolean equation using Boolean laws, which we even call as a Boolean algebra. So thank you.